Speaking about the United States as the beast with two horns, Revelation 13, 16 and 17 says, "And he causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name." The Bible says you won't be able to buy or sell unless you have the mark of the beast. But let's first identify the seal of God. Earthly rulers use seals to authenticate their authority. A seal contains the person's name, his title, and his territory. For example, Donald Trump, President of the United States. Donald Trump is his name, President is his title, and the United States is his territory. God's seal of authority is placed in the forehead. Revelation 7, 2 and 3 says, "And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living God, and he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, Hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our God in their foreheads." We find God's seal in the fourth commandment, which was written in stone, signifying its everlasting nature. Can you pick out God's name, title, and territory in the fourth commandment? Exodus 20, 8-11. "Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it." The Lord thy God is his name. His title is the one who made, or in other words, the creator. And the territory over which God reigns is heaven and earth. The fourth commandment is all about worshiping God on the seventh day Sabbath as a memorial of his creative power and as the ruler of heaven and earth. Exodus 31:13. "My Sabbaths ye shall keep, for it is a sign between me and you throughout your generations, that you may know that I am the Lord that does sanctify you." Please also read Ezekiel 20:20. By keeping the seventh-day Sabbath, we acknowledge God is our Creator and Lord. Now that the Bible has identified God's seal or his mark of authority, can you guess what Satan's counterfeit mark of authority is? Satan's mark of authority is the counterfeit Sunday Sabbath. C.F. Thomas, Chancellor of Cardinal Gibbons, said in answer to a letter regarding the change of the Sabbath, November 11, 1895, quote, "Of course, the Catholic Church claims that the change was her act, and the act is a mark of her ecclesiastical power and authority in religious matters," end quote. So Catholic authorities admit the act of changing the Sabbath from Saturday to Sunday is a mark of the papacy's ecclesiastical power and authority over religious matters. This mark of their authority is the mark of the beast. Note, according to the Bible, the mark of the beast is not received until after the two-horned beast, which is the United States, speaks like a dragon. This is done when it enforces Sunday observance through legislation. Years ago, Protestants were burned at the stake for opposing the unbiblical teachings and blasphemies of the papacy. But today, Protestants have been so deceived by Rome that they are now reaching out in blind, ignorant unity to embrace the papacy. God's seal of authority is his seventh-day Saturday Sabbath, and the papacy's mark of authority is the counterfeit Sunday. Some people may say it doesn't matter which day you keep, but it does matter to God, or he would not have commanded us to remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. The Sentinel, Pastor's Page, St. Catherine Catholic Church, Algonac, Michigan, May 21, 1995 states, "The holy day, the Sabbath, was changed from Saturday to Sunday. The day of the Lord was chosen not from any directions noted in the scriptures, but from the church's sense of its own power." In a book by Pope John Paul II titled Crossing the Threshold of Hope, page 3, 1994, he writes, "The leader of the Catholic Church is defined by the faith as the vicar of Jesus Christ and is accepted as such by believers. The Pope is considered the man on earth who takes the place of the second person of the omnipotent God of the Trinity. This is blasphemy. The Pope cannot take the place of Jesus." What does it mean to receive the mark of the beast in the hand or in the forehead? Simply put, the hand represents what you do and the forehead represents what you believe. If your actions or beliefs are supporting the counterfeit Sunday Sabbath, then you are on your way to receiving the mark of the beast once the Sunday laws are enforced. Who will you worship, God or the beast? I encourage you to reject the papacy's counterfeit Sunday and to follow Jesus by keeping God's holy seventh-day Saturday Sabbath. To learn more, email stmedia.co@gmail.com with your name and address for the free book, The Great Controversy Between Christ and Satan, available within the continental United States while supplies last. Outside the continental U.S., we'll send you the book in PDF format. So please email us today with your name and address, and we'll send you this free book, The Great Controversy, Past, Present, and Future. That address again is stmedia.co@gmail.com. May God bless you as you seek to learn and follow His will for your life as found in the Holy Bible. One final note, please do not request this book if you already have a copy in your home. Thank you, and God bless you.